Hey guys, good morning. Today, a special episode of Behind the Closed Doors. Now, we're in between trade shows, so we just finished Photo Days in Belgium, and this weekend we have Professional Imaging in the Netherlands. That means we take it a little bit slower. So yesterday, some cool stuff happened. We actually got a new banner for our open house, so mark your agenda if you're able to come. And Anna-Wiek and our intern put it on the building. So let's see what happened yesterday. But I'm also going to tell you some really cool stuff about an item that has come in that I've been waiting for a long time. So enjoy today's episode of Behind the Closed Doors.
So this is our outside banner and we're going to replace it with the one for the open house on June 3rd. And the weather is great, so shouldn't be a problem. You gonna open it, Kim?
Yes.
So you made this yourself?
I did.
In Photoshop or InDesign?
Photoshop.
Just Photoshop.
Yes.
Okay, and we used a photo of last open house.
Yes. Ta-da!
So show me! Well, when the open house is done, you can keep this one for your new room.
Thank you. Nice.
Oh, looks great. Wow. Okay, let's set up the time lapse and we're gonna change it outside. Received a package from DigiTrading, so I'm very curious what it is. It might be Frank's new Camfy. It's the only solution for Sony to shoot wireless. So I'm very curious how that works out. And yes, it is! It's the Camfy. So I'm gonna bring it to Frank now and he'll let you know more as soon as he knows more.
Okay, when I switched from Canon to Sony, there were a lot of hurdles at start because a lot of the companies didn't support Sony. And for example, if you wanted small strobes and you wanted radio triggers, it was terrible. With Sony, you didn't have any choice. With Canon and Nikon, there were plenty of choices. So we ended up with Photix and it worked great. And slowly, now today, you see that stuff is released on Canon, Nikon and Sony, and sometimes even on Sony first. There's one thing where Sony lagged behind, and it frustrated the heck out of me. What is it? Wireless tethering. Now, don't get me wrong, the app inside the camera, so if you take the camera, there's inside an app store, and you can download something called Smart Remote, and it works flawlessly. The only problem is, as soon as you're in smart mode, and I put my eye to the viewfinder, now normally it switches to the EVF, not with this Smart Remote. It stays on the back of my screen. So I made this contraption where I actually put a loop on and then I can use it, but it's not perfect. Although, in all honesty, pretty much is. If the EVF would be working, I wouldn't look at anything else, but the EVF isn't working. So I wanted something else. Now I've been bugging the guys from, for example, CamRanger and also KSR from our own tether tools for years. Come on guys, get a Sony solution. Now there were some units out there that said we're compatible with every camera. Well, not with Sony, but today I'm gonna show you the Camfy. Now what is the Camfy? It's actually a really small device like this, like the CamRanger. It has a network connector, it has USB, you can charge it via USB, and it promises to give you transfer of RAW files, JPEGs and whatever you want in camera control. Now, I'm not going to do a full review because, in all honesty, it's not done yet. So maybe it's the first time you're going to see it used on a Sony. They will have a new firmware that will be released soon. But I first want to show you just how it works and why I'm so incredibly enthusiastic about this device. Okay, delivered with the Camfy, you also get this U, I don't know how to call it, bracket. And this one you can put on your camera, and you can actually put the Camfy here and just put it on your tripod stand. So in my case of the Sony, it would actually mean that it's been connected like this. And that works pretty well. I'm just going to show you how the app works, and then when we do a proper review, I'm going to show you all the connection methods, because you can also put it on your hot shoe, of course, but then I can't use my triggers anymore. So for me, that doesn't make any sense. Okay, so what do they give you? They give you an app for your iPhone or iPad, Mac, and PC. And we're going to look at the Mac version and the iOS version, but I can tell you already, the Windows version works just as well. Okay, operating the Camfy is really simple. Again, this is not a review, so I'm just filming this with the vlog camera, so there will be a proper review later on. You just select the network from Camfy. There's no password on it at the moment, so that's fine for now. It connects to the network, and then the only thing you have to do is start up their app, which is free for Windows, macOS, and iOS. It immediately switches to full screen. And as you can see, we have all the settings here. So we can do a record for video, bracketing, stacking, time lapse, and whatever more you want. So let's see how fast the images come in. And I have to tell you guys, at the moment, it still transfers RAW and JPEGs. This is something they're working on. And in the next incarnation of the firmware, you will be able to just transfer the JPEGs and not the RAWs. But even the RAWs goes pretty fast. But I'm going to put my camera on JPEGs and show you guys how fast the 42 megapixel files will come in. And it might surprise you. Okay, this is the Mac version. Let's take a quick shot and see how fast it transfers the 42 megapixel files. There we go. And there you have the file. So that goes pretty fast, right? And this is the full resolution. Now, during workshops, I will never use the full resolution. I will probably do small JPEGs and big RAWs, but there's more. Okay, as you can see, the image is coming really fast, and that's the full resolution JPEG. So during workshops, I will actually lower the resolution to, let's say, 11 megapixels, and that goes even faster. Now, the reason for me is very simple. I love shooting tethered, and for workshops, I think it's essential. The students should be able to see exactly what I'm doing and check if their composition is the same as mine or if the lighting is correct, because if you just change a little bit, everything can be totally different. So I want my students not to look at the back of my camera, but actually see what I'm doing. And on most locations, it's okay to shoot tethered with wires, and we always use tether tools for that, of course. But in some locations, it's more like a run and gun. So it would be great if any week could just hold an iPad Pro. It's a big screen, and I could just shoot, go to the next location, change over, or if it's wet on the floor, you don't destroy your cables. Don't destroy your cables, but they get dirty, you know what I mean, right? So sometimes shooting with cables can be a hassle, and shooting wireless is great. Now, as a huge disclaimer, this device isn't ready yet. So they promised me a new firmware on March 13, which is actually now in the past. And I just emailed with them because we still have some problems with dividing between RAW and JPEGs, as I told before. But there's some more issues like stability and connection to several devices, because that's one of the cool things about the Camfy. It makes it actually possible to shoot to two or three devices at the same time. So you can have your iPhone, your iPad, and your Mac or PC, and just shoot one image and it will appear on all those devices. Imagine that for workshops. So we can give people an iPhone, we can give people an iPad, or they use their own, they download the app, and they can actually see on their own device the images coming in. So you don't have crowds gathering behind one display. You can just say, okay, download the app. If you don't have the app, find somebody who does in the group, and you can see the images straight on, like a one-on-one experience. So that's absolutely awesome. Now, I am waiting for the new firmware, and that's when I'm going to do a proper review for you guys. So this was just showing you that we got the thing in. So what's more on the agenda today? We're going to pack our cases for professional imaging, and we're going to build up there tomorrow. So I'm going to stop the vlog for today, because it is only packing cases, and you already saw that from the previous trade show. But this weekend, we will have special episodes dedicated to professional imaging. Gonna see if I can interview some of the speakers there, like Christiana Shirk and Glyn Dewis, and get some tips for you guys. And of course, show you how we build up the trade show floor and how we build up our own booth. So join us in future episodes of Behind Closed Doors. Now, again, as a disclaimer, this was not a review. It's just showing you guys what we got in, and it's pretty, pretty too early to do a proper review because we're still waiting for the firmware. But it's already great that it works on Sony, because other brands don't even have a solution that works. And I already saw it working. It works great, but they need to fix some of the stability stuff. And of course, make sure that we only can transfer JPEGs. So if you like what we do, please subscribe to our channel. Make sure you tell others about it so we can grow even more and give you guys more free stuff. Thank you so very much for watching, guys. And see you tomorrow at Professional Imaging, special episodes of the vlog. Bye-bye.